Welcome to part one of Flexible Assembly's Fastening Theory educational video. In this video, we will investigate the strength of a fastener, what torque is, and how it affects tightening. Let's start off by exploring the threaded fastener. Its function is to clamp two or more components together by acting as a heavy spring between the components. Under heavy loads, fasteners start to deform and change shape. They must be able to withstand the forces upon them to avoid failure. The total scope of all the components being clamped together and the fastener is called the bolted joint. The support surface on the fastener, which mates to the part that it will be clamping, is called the bearing surface. Preload is the state of a bolt's tensile load, its capacity for being able to withstand being pulled apart, while clamp load is the state of a joint's compressive load, its capacity to withstand loads while being pushed together. Both of these types of loads, although opposite, rely on the structure of the bolt and joint to be strong enough to resist deformation from compression or stretching. Let's take a deeper look into the fastener strength. Here is a graph where the black line represents fastener strength. Torque, or stress, is represented on the y-axis, while strain is on the x-axis. As stress and strain increase, the fastener will eventually reach a limit and fracture. The yield strength of a fastener is the point of stress which the material it is made from starts to deform permanently. The proof load of the fastener is its usable strength where it will return to its original shape once the load is removed. This is typically 85 to 95% of the yield strength. The ultimate tensile strength is where the fastener is pulled to the point of breaking and fracturing. This is where the fastener will fail completely. While a fastener remains in the elastic range, it can deform safely and return to its original shape once the load is removed. However, once it passes into the plastic range, it will remain permanently deformed. Let's review by breaking down tightening into four phases. Phase 1 is rundown, where there is no contact between the fastener or the components being clamped. Phase 2 is drawdown, where the joint is seated and there is contact between all the components being clamped. Phase 3 is elastic deformation and clamp load buildup. Clamp load, also called preload, is created when torque is applied and is the primary goal when tightening. Phase 4 is plastic deformation. This is where we hit our yield strength and the fastener begins to deform permanently. All fasteners have a manufacturer's rating for their strength. Making sure you have the right fastener for your job is important to avoid failure. Now, let's examine torque and why we need to measure it when achieving clamp force. First off, what exactly is torque? Simply put, torque is a measure of how much force acting on an object causes that object to rotate on an axis. There are a few components. The first is the pivot point, which is generally in the center of our fastener, acting as an axis. The second is the force that is applied. The third is the moment arm, which is the distance from the pivot point to where the force is actually applied. So torque is a cross product of the magnitude of force and the perpendicular distance from the force to the axis of rotation. The longer the moment arm is, the more leverage can be used to result in higher torque. Imagine a door. The hinge is our pivot point. Pushing on the door is our force. And the moment arm is how close we push on the door in relation to the hinges. By pushing on the door right next to the hinges, we don't create much torque. However, if we push with the same force on the edge opposite of the hinges, we create much more torque, easily swinging the door open. A hinge doesn't tighten under this torsional force, but a threaded fastener does, and thus creates bolt tension and a clamping force. How is torque measured? Let's take a closer look. The first point we will examine is labeled O. This is the axis of rotation that our wrench is free to move around. Next we have P, which is where our hands will be applying force at the end of the wrench. The distance between O and P is labeled R and represents the moment arm. When force is applied perpendicularly to the wrench, we get our applied force vector, which is labeled as F. This vector combined with the vector from the wrench creates an angle between them, which is labeled as theta. The product of multiplying the force, moment arm, sine, and theta together is torque. This shows how, if we were to tighten the same bolt with the same amount of force, but instead used a longer wrench, our moment arm would be a higher value, thus creating more torque through leverage. Torque is not energy. It's a cross product of two vectors and must be labeled in such a way. We use Newton meters, or pounds feet, and similar units to do so. But what do those units of measure mean? 1 newton meter is equal to the torque resulting from a force of 1 newton applied perpendicularly to a moment arm which is 1 meter long. Similarly, 1 pound foot is the same, but using 1 pounds of force and a 1 foot long moment arm. How else can we achieve 1 newton meter of torque? Assuming we are applying the force perpendicularly, we can use twice the force and half the length moment arm to reach 1 Newton meter. But why measure torque at all when our goal with tightening is to achieve clamp force? Measuring torque is easy to implement and control since we measure it from the fastener that we are applying force to. To measure clamp force would require placing a scale between the mating surfaces, which can't be done while tightening without having to later remove that scale during the final rundown. Measuring torque can be tricky, however, since you have to account for many forms of friction, as we will discover in our next Fastening Theory video. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments. And remember to subscribe to Flexible Assembly so you don't miss out on part 2 of the series.